Learn how easy it can be to switch your Power BI reports from your sandbox or your dev environment to production using things like Dynamics Business Central. Learn all about it and more this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today is a special edition because it's the first time we're having a super user on the show. So I want to welcome Babatunde to the show. Thanks so much for joining us. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do, and maybe a bonus, a little bit about what you do in the super user, like what that means?
Oh, thank you, Anna. My name is Babatunde Dallas, and I'm a business intelligence analyst and developer. Basically, what I do is I help my organization in presenting reports. And I have to go and get those data, and it has come to a situation whereby I don't know how to even get some data myself. And I start asking questions within the Power BI environment. And luckily, I look at what questions people are also asking, and I begin answering those questions. And ever since then, I have learned so much, and I'm happy here today to be a super user on the group, on the community group, and I'm here to share you my experience and what I have come, difficulties I have come across during my progress.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Cool. Well, it's great to have you on the show. And yeah, for folks who don't know, Babatunde's super active on the Fabric communities and the Power BI communities, and that opens up opportunities like coming on Data Exposed. So great. Today, we're going to be talking about something I know nothing about, so I'm really excited to learn something from you today, and I think our viewers will as well. And we're learning about developer productivity in Fabric, specifically around how to get data from Business Central. And I wanted to start by just asking you to tell us a little bit about the scenario and why customers might be trying to do this.
Oh, thank you again. Reason being is because most organizations are using Business Central, and it is a necessity demand for we business intelligence developer to know how we can get our data out of Business Central by exposing some fields. You know, those fields are customized fields, but once those fields have been exposed, we also need to organize them well, because we are not just using those fields for Power BI reports. We might share them as an API link to some other business aspect of the business, maybe a DVR screen or whatever, or a dashboard, some other department and using to get them work. But the difficulties I've come along on this product is what I wanted to share is how we can easily connect from one environment. Because in most cases, we as a developer, we start from sandbox environment and we want to point into production once we are going live. But then I have come to a situation whereby some reports are being developed, but those reports were not developed in the right structure that cost a lot of time in trying to move to production. And it should be just one easy click. And that's what I'm about to share with you today.
Oh, cool. That sounds awesome. Everybody loves to hear that. Okay, cool. I understand the scenario. Let's take a look if you're ready.
Okay. Thank you. First, I'm going to start with Business Central environment and an object called Simple Object Designer. And with Deep Designer, what basically do is we can use it to develop an API, and we can read those API in our Power BI environment or expose data that we wanted to expose within Business Central environment. And now let's go into my Fabric environment back. I'm going straight into the data flow. I have it open right here. These are the tables I'm working with. And this is the place we are working in today. First and foremost, let's say we've already got one. These are the tables of API that I created or I exposed using the Simple Object Designer. And these are the lists right here. I've created customer tables, sales header, and sales invoice line. Another thing I'm going to talk about right here is this is an API environment. If we create a report with these three fields, this mm-hmm. three table, and these tables are currently living in sandbox environment, and I need to expose them in production, all we need to do is extend get the extensions from the sandbox and upload it back in our business central environment, production environment, then we'll be able to point this. And apart from that, this is what I want to work on with you today. Again, is how to easy way to connect data from different environments. Right now, this is my company environment, and in this company environment, this is my sandbox environment. But for today, I have three sandbox. I have two sandbox environments and one production. So what I want to do is, after developing a report like this, all we need to do is come change this endpoint. Let me copy this to copy of production. I can easily come here and apply. And once that is done, I can also see the same set of data in a different, from different sandbox or different environments. Let's give this a minute. Okay. If this run into an error, but which I hope not, thank God, no error. And this is because the same field is being opened in this environment. And likewise, I can still go back and change this to previous field, or let me just say, I'm going straight to production. We are good and we have, let's believe we have this, this field has been also opened in production environment, and all I need to do is come to my environment right here and just change this endpoint to production, apply, and it's going to apply. So what does this mean is, what does it mean to us is, it's easy to point from one location to another and from one environment to another environment. Come to think of this, if I have three more different endpoint. I have seen a report whereby we have three different endpoints, and when it's time for us to go live, it's very difficult coming back and changing endpoint. We are unable to change the endpoint because of how the data set is being structured. Oh, that is not here, right here. Right here. Right here. Combos. Shut off account. Now, this is what I'm talking of. This account is using different environment. This is in a different environment. So let's say both of these reports are live, both of these reports, sales dashboard and customer shut off accounts, are in the same environment right now. Let's say UAT. And I need to transfer them to, or point them to production. Without these two reports, these two tables are being structured, I have to manually change these two tables separately. I have to come here, change this UAT to another production environment, cancel that, and also do the same thing here separately. Then imagine when we have tens of tables to deal with. This comes to time being waste or stressful, or it gives us a lot of stress in that. So all I expect, all I advise is, before you can create a Power BI or get your data from BC, it's easy. Just let's start with from get data set. I have already connected the data right here, but for demonstration purpose, I'm going to do that again. Say Business Central. Key in all the information. Let me do that. Production environment. My company name, and type of endpoint I want to use, right here. Edit credentials, sign in. One minute.
Awesome. So while this is completing, just to recap what you've done, you showed us how much easier your life can be if you take advantage of environment variables and how easy those are to set up. So that's awesome. And then now once you've set it up, you're going through and connecting to now bring the data in from Business Central, right?
Yes. After that page, this is exactly what I'm supposed to get back, whereby it will be more easier for me. So this, after that, this is what I'm going to get in return. Right here, Business Central Dynamics 365 once after logging into the page. And this is basically what I'm going to see right here. Then I can then easily come and point my environment where I'm going, which type of data set I want to pull out from that environment. And once I finish productivity, you know, or another way we can do about it, it's easily coming here by declaring our variables, tenant variables first, saying this is the tenant, declaring the tenant variable companies and environment without us logging the, you know, keying in those in credentials using the Microsoft functions in the connection in the under the get data page Business Central environment. We can also use blank query to create this environment, to create the connection access point directly to Business Central again. And that is much easy, and which is what I have demonstrated today, where it's easy to just change this endpoint location without ensuring you develop all reports with an endpoint location, whereby it will be more easier to come and change it other than putting all the link of each table separately. Thank you.
Awesome. Cool. This was great. I think I learned a lot. I think probably our viewers did too. So thanks so much for coming on the show. One final question I have for you is, any tips or tricks for folks who are kind of just getting started with this or trying to make this work?
Yeah. One big tip is Microsoft Learn, and or let's say start with Google. Another very good tip is start with Copilot. Reason being is because I use Copilot to answer most of my Microsoft questions, to just ask, and that have given me a edging point to just land me directly to the most resources tools, especially the Microsoft Learn or Box other people have written about. So best advice is ask always. I won't say Google, I will say Copilot now, because it's more been refined to your search. So I'll say use Copilot to search when you have any problem, and you can always move from there.
Cool. Awesome. I love it. Thanks so much, Babatunde, for coming on the show, being our first super user on the show. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, let us know what you think. We also will put some links in the description below for you to learn more. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.